Hello friends, this is Durga again from ITVarsity, a one-stop shop to learn all the technologies. At this time, we are talking about getting started with NoSQL database called MongoDB for developers. And so far, we have covered introduction, installation on Mac, and the data structure about MongoDB. And as part of this video, we will try to cover about a few details about Mongo Shell and also basic commands in Mongo Shell. Okay, before launching Mongo Shell, you have to make sure the Mongo database is up and running. The way you can do it is by running Mongo command and hit enter. If it is up and running, it will launch the Mongo CLI, otherwise it will fail. So if it fails, then what you have to do is, you have to just run the MongoD command, as I have shown earlier as part of the installation. Like this, --db path to give the path for the database, --fork to run it in the background, --logpath to redirect the logs to the log file. And this is the, even if you just type MongoD, once it is up and running, you will see this information that it is already started and it is running. So even you can use MongoD command to confirm that the MongoD or Mongo server is up and running or not. If it is up and running, just type Mongo and hit enter. You will get into the Mongo server by connecting to a default database called test. So test is a default database in Mongo. You can just say db and hit enter. It will show the database you are connected to. Okay, so this is how you can launch the Mongo shell and get into the database, Mongo server, and then it will automatically connect to test. And you can get the details about the database you are connected to by running db command. And test will be out of the box with Mongo. And if you want to see what all collections that are there, so collections is the term which we use in Mongo. It's not tables. We use collections, and there will be there is no we typically don't use the term called record or row to for the record in Mongo collection. Instead, we call it as document. So collection is group of documents that are stored in that collection. So there is no collection in this database. So we can create a collection. There is no command such as db. So there is a command called db.createCollection if you want to create the collection. Also, if you want to type a command that is relevant to the scope of the database that is currently connected to, you can use db command dot. And if you are not sure about the command, if you assume that create might be the prefix for the create database command, and hit tab, you have to hit tab twice. It will have all the attributes over there. So you can use db dot create collection to create the collection, but there is no need to do that. There is another way of creating the collection, which I will be covering in a moment once I talk about the databases. So related to databases, if you want to create a new database other than database test, you can use show databases to list all the databases. At this time, so when we run showdbs command, it will only show the database which have collections. It doesn't show the databases which does not have the collections. So to create the database, first you have to do is you have to say use whatever database you want. So I want to create a database called HR. So use HR, and we already switched database to HR. And if you run DB, it will show the current database. And if you run show DBs, it will not show HR because HR does not have collections. You can validate that by running show collections. Okay. As there is no collections, still, even though you are connected to database HR, it's only logical connection. Once you start creating collections, so it will start showing the database list. Otherwise, if there are no collections in a database, it will consider as an it will be considered as that the database is not created once you are out of the session. So use is the command to create the database and also to connect to the database. It works like if not exists. So for example, if you say use to an existing database, then it will connect to the database. If the database does not exist, it will create the database and then it will connect to it. Okay, so in this case, right now we are connected to HR, and if you want to create a collection called employees, there is a command called create collection. If you want, you can create that. Otherwise, you can directly say db.employees.insert. Okay, and then you can start giving the parameters such as employee number. If it is numeric, you don't need to specify the data types. Ename, some person, and then make sure you close the brackets appropriately, close the double quotes appropriately, and hit enter. Now the record is inserted into the database. Now you can say show collections, and the collection is available. And also, if you run show DBs, the database will be displayed here once the collection is created with a row inserted. Okay, so this is how you can create a database by just using command use HR and create one collection. Even if it is empty, I guess you will start seeing the database. Otherwise, the database will not be created permanently. It will be only connected as long as you are in the session after creating the new database using use command. Unless there is no collection in it, it will not be persisted permanently. So this is how you can launch the Mongo shell and start typing the commands. You can also run db.employees.find to get the records from the collection or get the documents from the collection. We should use the term collection, documents and collections rather than records and tables. And if you want to beautify, you can also use pretty and hit enter. And while doing this, if you are not sure about the command, you can just say find, and if you want to use limit to get the number of only certain number of records. Find is there. So to get the limit 10. Anyway, we will talk about later. It is little bit out of scope. To get started, you don't need to worry much about it. But find is the command which you need to be aware, and pretty is to beautify the JSON. We will see the other things later. But you can perform the autofills in most of the cases by typing part of the command like this. Okay. I think it does not work for all levels, but after the collection name, it will show. It will autofill by hitting tab while typing the command. Okay, so this is about Mongo shell, how you can connect to it, how you create the database, how you create a collection by using insert command, and how you can actually read the data from the collection. That being said, going forward, we will cover the rest of the topics to be proficient enough to get started as a developer with MongoDB. We will start with Java, then we will cover the other programming languages also. That being said, I hope you are enjoying the content on the channel. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If you want to provide the feedback, please use the comment section of the video. And also, lately I have started setting up LMS platform. This course will be on the LMS also. You can leave the comments over there also if you want to provide the feedback. And if you are not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. And if you live in countries such as US, UK, where fan funding is supported, and if you start liking the content on the channel, please fund me so that I can come up with more and more content like this over time. Thank you. Bye.